every tiny step I take, larger their wide awake. Lead me close to you, and if only I could stay beneath your wings, and if only I could dwell among your presence. The highest of I am, and the biggest grace I have, only to be standing next to you. If only I could stay beneath your wings, and if only I could dwell among your presence. The highest hope I have, and the biggest grace I have, only to be standing next to you.
형 여기 사면 몇 개월 걸려요? 그거 리모델링? 바로 할게요. 1번 3번 1번 바로 할게요. 1번. 네.
shame and to join for praise forever. Oh, I thank you for the grace you've given me. I once was lost, but now I found your everything I need. I worship you, I live for you, you're all that from the west. You've taken away my worthlessness. You've turned my shame into joyful praise forever. Oh, I thank you for the grace you've given me. I once was lost, but now I found your everything I need. I worship you.
Praise, I am marvelous. Thank you.
centuries that cannot be described. The wonderful grace of the renewal brought up the cross. My spirit will rejoice in praise. I am marvelous, name of the Lord. Jump with joy. My spirit will rejoice in praise. I am marvelous, name of the Lord.
박현이네 좀 먼 길 왔잖아.
한 명이 나와서.
네 미안.
우유.
그래 누가? 야 다음 주 입으로 없어서 못 오는 거 아니야?
그래? 그 나 때문이네 시험 들어서.
그냥 봄용 옷을 하나. 진 때문에 나네.
내가? 하나 해주시고. 내가 그렇게 신앙 약하지 않아.
좋아.
이렇게 약한 아이가 아니야. 오늘은 현석이 안 와요?
오늘 그 밀접 접촉자를.
현석이?
그래서 못 왔어.
덕경아 오늘 네가 방송 잡니? 잘 부탁해.
내 마이크 안 나오게 하는 거 아닌데?
누나 마이크 꺼.
그래 내 거 내려. 내 거 괜찮아. 내 마이크 돼.
내 마이크
끊고.
괜찮아 다 용서해 줄 수 있어.
괜찮아 안 나와도
다 용서해.
괜찮아.
부모는 찾아야겠다.
네, 언니, 그게 그렇게 웃긴 일이에요? 너무 시선이 집중됐나?
아니, 우리가 생각지 못하다 네가 말하니까 진짜 그래요? 딱 그게 보이는 거 같아.
자기네들은 옷 얇게 입어놓고 왜.
제발 옷 벗었잖아.
자기네들은 다 얇게 입어놓고.
예, 오늘 사회요?
너 사회할 때는 인혁이를 안 쳐다. 인혁이 사회할 때 네가 앉아있고.
오늘 어떻게 사회자 너무 없어요.
그러니까. 그러면 여기서 또 부르는 거야?
어, 여기서
항상 사회. 크게.
광훈 집사님. 광훈 집사님.
우리 시작해야 돼?
네?
시작해? 아 그래?
아니 안 되는 거 아니야 시간? 몇 분이야?
아니 저게 안 맞죠. 거의 맞을 거예요. 자 우리 곧 시작하겠습니다 여러분. Soon we're gonna have a today service. Let's prepare our heart. We'll meet the word soon, so let's prepare it.
Shiloh의 조명 좀 놔드려야겠어요.
네. 너한테만 핀 조명을 써야 되겠는데. 너도 오늘 까마네. 왜 그러지? 우리가 너무 밝아서 그런가?
원래 그렇거든.
아니야, 너 오늘 까매.
It's time. It's 2:10 now. Let's begin today's worship with the prayer. Shiloh, let's pray together. Father, thank you for opening service. We all are here to meet you and to hear your word. When you speak through Pastor James, the word, help us listen to him and make us know your heart. Father, please come close to us. We need you more and more. And we want to know your heart. Father, please give us discerning heart. Make us know what is good and what is evil in these chaotic times. So help us to walk the path you want to walk with us. We give all the glory and honor to you. We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for our sins. Amen.
Of the
the rushing of his mighty spirit sweet. He brought his love and hope and joy to us again. We will give him the glory, give him the honor.
My
아멘. Let's pray for our sins. Let's repent first. For my sin, for my family's sin, my church's sin, my nation's sins. Let's repent for our sins. And then let's pray for the nations, wherever you're from, like Ukraine, or like Russia, or like Korea. But there's lots of big event like war or presidential election, lots of things are. Let's pray for that, for our nations. And for our church, let us pray for the senior pastor who will become, and through him, the redemptive history word will be spread continuously, endlessly. Let's pray for him. And let's pray for Shiloh. When you pray for Shiloh, please remember this name, Pastor James, first, who will teach us. God will speak through him. So let's pray for him first. And then Evangelist Joanna Pei, let's pray for her. She's in Korea now. Maybe next week we will meet her. So let's pray for her. And especially, please pray for Pastor Jabez. He's with us now, but by next week he will be here. But 2 weeks later, he will not be here so far. So let's pray for him, for his work. And please, God, for him, let's pray. And for Shiloh, Ominshik, Pastor John McCauley, Roxanne, Jessica Hemi, Malaysia's Madeline, Elders Madeline's family. Let's pray for them. Maybe there's lots of names here. And some people are in need of our prayer because of economic problem, or someone because of the test, lots of things, lots of works. So let's pray for them. We're going to pray together after singing this song, I Stand Just As I Am.
I stand just as I am. You still love me, Lord, with all my weaknesses. You still cherish me. Every tiny step I take, Lord, you're there wide awake. Lead me close to you. I stand just as I am. You still love me, Lord, with all my weaknesses. You still cherish me. Every tiny step I take, Lord, you're there while away. Lead me close to you.
Every tiny step I take, Lord, you're there.
need to be standing next to you.
Shiloh, let's pray together. Shout Amen, Hallelujah, three times. Amen, Hallelujah. Amen, Hallelujah. Amen, Hallelujah.
In spite of the chaos and deep darkness. Father God, we confess that it was your blessing of Sabib to guide and lead us for the last week. Even though it's unstable and difficult time, make us strong and be bold with your majesty so that we can give unsparing devotion and keep praying to you like Nehemiah and Daniel. Father, although we are weary and helpless in these tribulations, even if we are going through a lot of troubles and problems like the wilderness, please be with us until the end and show your mercy and embrace us with your love and make us to be born again through water and Holy Spirit and finally make us to be sanctified by your word so that we are able to accomplish your work and achieve salvation together. Be united as one. Father God, at this time, may your Holy Spirit be upon your beloved servant, Reverend James Park, so that our daily life can be changed according to your will through your blessing and power as he proclaimed the word. And may your grace be upon Shiloh Choir as they give precious praise to you so that every choir member can give thanks and only glorify your holy name. This time, guide us and may your Holy Spirit be upon us from the beginning to the end. All these things we pray in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The bread of life today comes from Ezra chapter 4, verse 1 through 5. Once again, Ezra chapter 4, 1 through 5. Believing you have found, now we will read. Now when the enemies of Judah and Benjamin heard that the people of exile was building a temple to the Lord God of Israel, they approached Zerubbabel and the head of father's household and said to them, "Let us build with you, for we, like you, seek your God. And we have been sacrificing to him since the day of Esarhaddon, king of Assyria, who brought us up here. But Zerubbabel and Jeshua and the rest of the heads of the fathers' households of Israel said to them, 'You have nothing in common with us in building a house to our God, but we ourselves will together build to the Lord God of Israel, as King Cyrus, the king of Persia, has commanded to us.' Then the people of the land discouraged the people of Judah and frightened them from building, and hired counselors against them to frustrate their counsel all the days of Cyrus, king of Persia, even until the reign of Darius, king of Persia." This is the word of God. Now we will have choral anthem.
Like a rose trampled on the
come up. Give a sermon titled CMA Lecture 5, Interference in the Temple Construction.
Thank you so much from the Shiloh Choir. Let me get set up here. Hopefully this will connect. Okay. And we are in the period of Lent right now, and that was such a nice selection because we are following in the footsteps of Jesus and thinking about his resurrection, his cross. Hold on one second here. Okay. So thank you so much for that wonderful praise. You reminded us that we are following in the footsteps of Jesus, and we are taking upon our cross and denying ourselves. One second here. Every week, something just doesn't go right. Does it work? Okay. Okay, and also from the Shiloh praise team, thank you so much for your wonderful praise, and really all of the lyrics and the words are a real blessing, and it really touched our hearts, I believe, and I believe that God was glorified. Amen? Can I get an amen? Amen. In America, you know, we have to, you know, really get into it, you know, interact with each other. Can I get an amen? Amen. Through today's main passage, read by our General Secretary David, I want to share the message here, interference in the temple construction. Interference in the temple construction. You know what? Okay, one second. I'm going to switch it. Okay. Is this working? Okay. Interference in the temple construction. So, as the construction of the temple began in 536 BC, we saw that the adversaries began to interfere with the work of the temple. And so they were only able to lay the foundation. So only the foundation was laid. And as soon as the work began on the construction of the temple, the adversaries came and began to interfere. So Ezra chapter 4, verse 4, if you follow along in your workbooks and on the screen, can we read that together? Ready, begin. Then the people of the land discouraged the people of Judah and frightened them from building. So these two key words, discouraged and frightened. So whenever God's people are trying to build up the kingdom of God and doing his work, Satan is not going to remain still. And so this teaches us that we need to truly be alert and ready and be fully armed with the armor of God so that we may withstand all of the schemes of the evil one. And so you and I need to be armed with the word of God, with truthfulness, and with prayer so that we may be able to have the victory. I pray that through today's word that is given today, may God give you the victory in Christ Jesus, and may you be able to become victors and the remnant. And I pray and bless this upon you in the name of the Lord. Amen. Can I get an amen? Amen. So first, the enemies demanded that they be allowed to join in the construction work. So the enemies of Judah came and they made a demand. Hey, we want to work with you. And so this was like a trickery. You know, they're pretending that they wanted to help. You know, oh, we'll help you and we'll supply all of the needs and we'll come and join you. And this is in Ezra chapter 4, verse 1 and 2. And the Bible clearly says the enemies of Judah and Benjamin heard that the people of the exile were building a temple. And they said, let us build with you. And this is not just a polite request, but it's a demand. They wanted to force themselves into taking part in this work. And so we see that they came with this mask, you know, looking good on the outside, but they had evil intent. So this is the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. So their words were good, but their intent was evil. And we have to recognize that. We always have to be discerning. Some people, they say good words, it looks good, but inside there is evil intent. And so we always have to pray for God's wisdom to discern what is good and what is evil. So the enemies of Judah, who are they? The enemies of Judah and Benjamin refer to the people of Samaria. So this is the answer, Samaria. The people of Samaria. Ezra 4:2, it says, they approached Zerubbabel and the heads of fathers' households and said to them, let us build with you, for we, like you, seek your God. And we have been sacrificing to him since the days of Esarhaddon, king of Assyria, who brought us up here. And so they were coming and saying, we've been here, you know, for a long time. And they were basing their request upon tradition. We've been here a long time. We've been worshiping here. And we want to help you. But this was a mask that they put on. So to explain the historical background, after the northern kingdom of Israel was destroyed by Assyria in 722 BC, the Assyrian king Esarhaddon, it's in our main passage today, Esarhaddon forced the Gentiles to move into the region of northern Israel. And so he forcefully migrated Gentiles, non-believers, into the northern Israel land. And the people of the northern kingdom of Israel mixed with the Gentiles, resulted in a mixed race called the Samaritans. And if you remember, John chapter 4, verse 1, Jesus came through the land of Samaria. It's in the northern kingdom. And he talked with the woman at the well. And people did not associate, Jews did not associate with Samaritans because they were mixed. And especially they didn't associate with mixed women as well. 2 Kings 17:24, and the king of Assyria, King Esarhaddon, brought men from Babylon and from Cutha and from Ava and from Hamath and Sepharvaim and settled them in the cities of Samaria in the place of the sons of Israel. So they possessed Samaria. So you see, this was one of the political schemes of the evil one to mix the people. And that's what happened. Second, what happened? The returnees refused the demands of the enemies. So they refused. They said, no, you cannot take part in our work. We will have no part with you. So Ezra 4:3, it says that you have nothing in common with us in building a house to our God, but we ourselves, by ourselves, will together build to the Lord, God of Israel, as King Cyrus, the king of Persia, has commanded us. So they said adamantly, no, you cannot join us. And so, what is the reason that the people of Israel refused? It is because the Samaritans had syncretic beliefs. Syncretic beliefs. And what does this mean? They believed in God, but with other gods at the same time. So they believed in many gods. So they said, oh, we believe in Jehovah God, but they also believed in other gods. So this is called syncretic beliefs, syncretic beliefs. 2 Kings 17:33 says, they feared the Lord, but they served their own gods according to the customs of the nation. So they did not serve the one and only God himself, but they served other gods. It was mixed. So, you know, it's taking on different philosophies. And since the Samaritans did not believe in the one and only true God, what did they say? They expressed it as your God. They didn't say my God or our God, but they said your God. So let us build with you, for we, like you, seek your God. So this was very impersonal. This was impersonal. Christians, we have a personal relationship with God. We have personal relationship with Father, right? Personal relationship. As born-again believers, we have a direct link to Father God. And it's a personal relationship. And most of you are married. And when we are in a relationship, we communicate with each other. You know, we talk with each other and we listen. And this is a relationship that we have. But they said, this is your God. And also, why did the people refuse? Because the Samaritans had political ambitions. And so what does that mean? The Samaritans had been living in the region before the returnees came back from captivities. So when the Israelites went to Babylon, that land was not totally empty. And what happened was that Gentiles started to take control in some of the areas of Jerusalem or Samaria in the different regions. And so they took this political control. And so they didn't want to lose that control, right? And so by participating in the construction of the temple, they wanted to retain political stronghold in the region and eventually put the returnees under their control. So it's all about putting the returnees under their control. We'll help you, but you have to do what we say. So I don't know, some of you may work in kindergartens in Korea. The government helps subsidize kindergartens and, those places where they have children and educate them. But even though the government subsidizes and helps, they have their own curriculum. And they say, you have to teach this. And sometimes it is not congruent to Christian beliefs. And so sometimes when people want to help, it's not that they want to help, but they want to control. And so this is what they wanted to do. They wanted to put the people under control. But since the people rejected the demands, the enemies started to interfere right away. And so, as we said, they discouraged and they frightened. They discouraged and frightened. And what else was the reason why they rejected their demands? It is because it was God's command. God's command. God told King Cyrus to let the people go and to build a temple for me. And there was no command to build the temple with the Samaritans. So if you look at Ezra 4:3, it says that you have nothing in common with us in building a house to our God, but we ourselves will build to the Lord, God of Israel, as King Cyrus, the king of Persia, has commanded us. And King Cyrus says, you go build a temple with your people, only the people of Israel. And that was the command of Cyrus, but Cyrus was commanded by God, as we know. And one in Ezra 1:3 says, whoever there is among you of all his people, his, God's people, may his God be with him. Let him go up to Jerusalem, which is in Judah, and rebuild the house of the Lord. And so clearly it says that those who are God's people are commanded to go up and build the temple, God's people. So I believe that you and I are God's people, and we have a task of building the kingdom of God. What are we building here? We are building our personal faith, but we are also building Shiloh so that we can be able to proclaim the gospel to the nations, to the people all around the world. Third, let's look at the interference from the enemies. So the enemies of the land, what did they do? They discouraged. They discouraged the people. They discouraged. So if you look at discouraged, there's this root word, courage. Courage. So you know the word courage, right? And to discourage someone, is to take out the courage and to take out their morale. And literally, it means to weaken the hands. It means to weaken the hands. So it's to take out the courage, to frighten them and weaken the hands so that they will just not be able to work. And let's look at the Hebrew word for that. So discouraged is the PL, emphatic participle form of the word rapach, meaning to dishearten, to fall limp, and to made helpless. And when it is used with hand, it means to lose morale, to lose heart, or be disheartened, to be frightened. And frightened is the word bala. It means to frighten. So what does this mean? The enemies were using intimidation. They were using fear, you know, bringing weapons and, you know, making it look like they want to start a war. And the people were being frightened and discouraged. And, you know, they didn't want to build the temple anymore. And this is the plan of Satan. He uses people to dishearten, discourage, and to make people fall into despair. Oh, it's hopeless. There's no use. This is, you know, going nowhere. And so there's this kind of negativity to stop the word of God from going forward. So it's to frighten. I pray that when you get discouraged, that please look to Jesus and the promises that he has given you in his word. When we are holding on to God's word, there is no despair, but we can be able to go forward with courage, and by faith, we can go forward. What did Joshua say? He says, I cannot go into this land because I'm so weak. But God said, be strong and take courage. Be strong and take courage. Shiloh, I want to tell the president and the elders and the ministers, take courage and be strong and be able to have confidence to take this word to all of the nations. Our pastor Jabez is now going to America and working on the work that God is assigning there. And God is saying to pastor and all of us, be strong in heart and take courage, for I am with you. I believe that God is with us. Amen? Amen. So no matter how Satan interferes, we must not become discouraged. 2 Corinthians 4:8-9. Shall we read that together? Let's read that together. It's in your books and on the screen there. Ready? Begin. We are afflicted in every way, but not crushed, perplexed, but not despairing, persecuted, but not forsaken, struck down, but not destroyed. So even though we are pressed and afflicted and persecuted, and we have all of these trials, we do not need to despair because God, our God the Father, is with us. He is with us. And we have a great hope that he will accomplish the work. So, Shiloh, there is two kinds of work. The work that God does and the work that man does. Man puts his effort and sweat and tears. But in man's work, it will always fall down and crumble. But God's work will never fall down, but it will always go forward. Do you believe that? Amen. And it is not by might or by strength, but God says, but my spirit alone. That's what God is saying. It's not by our wisdom. It is not by our knowledge. It is not by our strength. Oh, I can do it, but only by the Spirit of God. So be encouraged. It's not me that's doing it, but Father God is working. Father God is working in the hearts of us and giving us the faith and the courage to work in his work. If you can believe that, can you say amen? Amen. So the deeper the suffering gets, the stronger the life of Jesus manifests, guaranteeing the victory for the saints. So the more that we suffer for Christ, the more that his life is manifesting in our lives, the more that we get persecuted, the greater the glory is waiting for us. If you see 2 Corinthians 4:10, it says, we carry about in the body the dying of Jesus, that life of Jesus may be manifested in our body. And Colossians 2:15, He has disarmed already, disarmed the rulers and authorities. So you need to realize that Satan has already been defeated by law. Satan has already been defeated, and he has no right to give us disease or give us poverty or to interfere in our lives. And so we need to hold on to the word of God. Next, the enemies bribed counselors to frustrate the plans of the people. So counselors. So they hired counselors, and hired means that they bribed. So, you know, they gave envelopes, you know, under the table to frustrate the counsel of all the days of Cyrus, king of Persia, even until the reign of Darius. This is Darius the First, right? Darius the First. And Darius ruled from 522 BC to 486 BC. And so you know that the temple was seized from 536 to 520 BC. So all the way from the days of Cyrus to King Darius, this is Darius the First, we see that they bribed the people to frustrate the plans, to frustrate the plans. So who are the counselors? They refer to those who advised the king at that time. And so the word frustrate is parar, which means to annul and to crush and to break. So, you know, King Cyrus was, you know, all for building the temple, but they hired and bribed counselors to go against that and to always, you know, be opposing all of that work, to crush, to break. So it's parar. And, you know the word perez, it's also to break forth. It's the same kind of Hebrew word. So this means that the scheme to interfere with the construction of the temple was so severe that it was impossible to proceed with the work. So they just stopped and the work ceased. So in application, it may seem that Satan is triumphing for the moment, but it is merely a time period that is determined. So it seems that Satan is working, determined, but this is only a set time. And when that set time is over, then God will prevail. And so, you know, we look at this nation of Korea. Oh, it's, you know, so chaotic. And, you know, with COVID-19, and we look at the church, and there's so many things going on. But that time is determined. And when that time is over, God is going to clean house, and he's going to complete the work that he has started. Amen? And so, Philippians 1:6, it says, he who began a good work in you will complete it until the day of Christ Jesus. So God, who began a good work in your personal life, in the faith of your children, your spouse, he who began a good work with the church, he who began a good work with Korea will fulfill and complete it until the day of our Lord Jesus. Amen. So if God starts it, he will finish it. And you need to believe that. So don't look at the present circumstance now, but let's look at the future and look at the final product. Job 25 talks about that. The triumphing of the wicked is short, and the joy of the godless momentary. 2 Corinthians 4:17, for momentary light affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory far beyond all comparison. So Shiloh, my beloved Shiloh members, when you suffer for Christ on this earth, your glory in heaven becomes more brighter. You know, when we go to heaven, our glory will all be different. The brightness will not be the same. You know, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 40 and the following talks about that. Just as the glory of the sun and the stars and the moon are different in brightness, the difference will be in the brightness of our glory when we go into heaven. And so when you are persecuted or when you go through hardships, count it as glory and count it as something to give thanks to God. Amen. So let's give thanks to God for that blessing. It is blessing. And when God's appointed time comes, the forces of darkness will surely be destroyed. destroyed. So God will destroy. He will destroy the forces of darkness. And so Matthew 13:30 talks about that. Allow both to grow together. So the wheat and the tares are growing together. And so, you know, the people said, hey, why don't we just pluck out the tares? And Jesus says, no, don't pluck out the tares because you may pluck out the wheat at the same time. So let them alone until the end. And they, the wheat and the tare, they look so similar. They look the same. But once they bear fruit, it is, you know, 180 degrees difference. The wheat and the tares is so different. But when it's growing, it looks the same. But at the end, God will separate the wheat and the tares. So I pray that you may be the wheat and be able to be harvested into God's kingdom. Amen. Revelation 17:17 talks about that, and Revelation 20:10. And it says, the devil who deceived them was thrown into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are also there. And they will be tormented day and night forever and ever. So Satan will not be having the final victory, but God will have the final victory. And what happened was when the people, now we're looking at the life of the people, when they stopped working on the temple, the people lived a life that had everything blown away. Now, we're changing in time here. Now, they stopped working on the temple because the enemies interfered. But they didn't even pray or take interest anymore. They just forgot about God's temple. For how many years? 16 years. And because of that, they were living under calamity and curse. And they were living a life that had everything blown away. And Haggai 1:9 says, you look for much, but behold, it comes to little. When you bring it home, meaning when you save, I blow it away. Why? Declares the Lord of hosts. Because of my house, which lies desolate, while each of you runs to his own house. So it looks like that we're saving, but if we don't take interest and do what God is pleased with, he blows it all away. The people lived a life of calamities or plagues. They lived a life of disaster. Another same word is disaster. So why don't we read Haggai 1 verses 10 and 11 together? It's in your workbooks and on your screen. Ready, begin. Therefore, because of you, the sky has withheld its dew, and the earth has withheld its produce. And I called for a drought on the land, on the mountains, on the grain, on the new wine, on the oil, on what the grain produces, on men, on cattle, and on all the labor of your hands. So no matter how hard a person works, if God sends calamities, it is all worthless. But God promised blessings when they started rebuilding the temple. So Haggai 1:7-8 says, thus says the Lord of hosts, consider your ways. So consider, being, understand, and pray, and think deeply. Why is this happening to me? And God says, go up to the mountains, bring wood, and rebuild the temple, that I may be pleased with it and be glorified, says the Lord. And so, as we come to a conclusion, the enemies interfered with God's work. And as a result, they came into despair and they just put down the work and they forgot about it. And as time went on, they just cared about their own houses and their own lives. And they didn't even think about God's house that was left in desolate. And you have to remember, only the foundation was built, the foundation. And so it still looked like, you know, just a heap of ruins. There was no, you know, building of the walls yet. Only the foundation was there. And it was probably all, you know, dusty and, you know, it looked like it was just abandoned, Psalms 127, verse 1 and 2. Let's read that together. Unless the Lord, ready, begin. Unless the Lord builds the house, the labor in vain who build it. Unless the Lord guards the city, the watchman keeps awake in vain. It is vain for you to rise early, to retire late, to eat the bread of painful labors, for he gives to his beloved even in his sleep. Amen. So there's the work that men do, but there is the work that God does. And when God builds it, it will stand forever. Isaiah 55:11 says that when God's work comes out of his mouth, it will fulfill and return back to him, fulfilling the word and fulfilling the will that God had planned and that God had predestined from the ages. And so we have to now think about the word that is given to us today. Are we doing God's work? What are we building for God? Now, I just want to end off with a story here. Not a story, but to tell you the heart of our senior pastor, Reverend Abraham Park. Fison, Dr. Reverend Abraham Park. And this week, in March 13th, it is the Pyongyang Day. And on the 10th, we're going to be worshiping here together, right? On Thursday morning. But on Thursday, there's going to be a morning event for the family and Pastor Jabez and his family and all of those people who are related. And that's going to be on Sunday. And President will be going and some of the elders will be going there. But the reason why I mention again Pisan, Reverend Abraham Park, is that he has three desires. Do you know what his three wishes are? As children, do we know the desire of our father? What does our father want? And there is three specific desires and wishes that he had. And first of all, he wants to build a new temple, right? He always talked about the 120 meters by 120 meters, you know, that new temple. And so we need to pray for that. And we need to, you know, support that work. So new temple. And another work is also a school. And Pastor Jabez will be involved in the work of the school. The senior pastor's wish is to have a school that is accredited so that we can train missionaries and send them to the world. And there's so many foreigners here in Korea already. And we can bring them here, but they're already here. And we can grab them and share the word with them. And so we need to build the school. And not only that, but we need to build a memorial hall. And this is what the senior pastor, his son, Dr. Reverend Abraham Park. So memorial hall, the new temple, and also the new school. Let us pray for those three things. They are the wishes and desires of our Father. And when we take part in that with prayers and offerings and sacrifice physically and spiritually, God will bless us. And he will take care of us. I truly believe that. I truly, truly believe that when we do God's work, God will pour out all of the blessings upon you. Haggai 2:9, what does it say? From this day forth, I will surely bless you. That word bless is barak. And it is in the imperfect PL form. Meaning God will continually, strongly pour out all of the big blessings on you. Continually and forever. And so when you start to do God's work, may the heavens be opened and may Shiloh be recovered and may our personal lives, our families, and may also our businesses and this nation be able to rise again and be able to reflect God's glory. And I pray and bless this upon you in the name of the Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this blessed and Holy Lord's Day, where we can come to you to study the History of Redemption series through the CMA. Father, you have given us a great vision to spread the word of God to all of the nations. Help us to think about your work and take part. And may we be able to use our gifts and talents to the work that you have given to us. We thank you in all these things we pray. In Jesus' precious name with thanksgiving, amen. Let's give glory to God. Amen.
We have been greatly blessed by the word. remembering his grace, let us sing hymn number 386. Hymn number 386. March on us all with thanks, like those strong men of old, who gazed in yonder rock to confident and bold, who trust in prison orchestra, light and glory in your name. The sons of fathers we, by whom our faith is taught, to fear no ill, to fight, the holy fight they fought. Heroic warrior near from Christ, then he lured the galling ties. March on our soul with train, and on the battle's roll, can the endless song make courage rule our soul. In kings to tribe, Lord, may we stand upheld and strengthened by your hand. Not long the conflict the holy worship cease, faith, warfare, and the war, the home of endless peace. Look up the victor crown and length, shone on march of victory train. Amen. Now, Elder Joseph Oak will come up with offering prayer.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, thank you for giving us this great day. We also thank you for blessing us daily by your grace. Please make us understand how you love and take care of us. So please forgive us when we forget your love and grace in our lives. And we pray that we live with your guidance. This is the season of Lent. Please always let us live every day with reverence. Every week, Father's redemptive words become spiritual proof for us. Father God, please let us know Father's redemptive words completely. Now is the time to give offering. Father God, please allow this offering to be used for heavenly work. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
We're going to have announcement time before we have introduction for newcomer. And please turn to your bulletins for the announcement. I know, but Pastor Will, he will introduce the newcomers after the announcement, please. For Pyungkang leadership, let us continue to pray for God's will to be realized through this election process. Whoever is in this position, may he continue to spread the history of redemption service around the world. An update on our worship restrictions, with the numbers of infected patients still high nationwide, the Shiloh sanctuary will only allow up to 30% of capacity, which is 24 persons total. For all worship service, including the Lord's Day, main service and Shiloh service, besides the essential team members needed for worship, like praise worship and broadcasting teams, plus choir, attendance will be based on cell group number. Next week it's an even number cell group turn. In addition, if you or someone you know have become infected with COVID-19 and attended worship at Shiloh Sanctuary recently, please contact President Luke Jung, your cell leader, or any of the leaders immediately. Out of an abundance of caution and for everyone's safety, we must alert other Shiloh members who may need to get tested right away. We thank everyone for your cooperation. And welcome back to Pastor Jabez and Evangelist Joanna, who have come back from Indonesia and America, respectively. Let's pray for their ministry and health continuously. About Lent, this year, the season of Lent begins on Wednesday, March 2nd, and lasts for 40 days, not counting each Lord's Day until Easter, April 17th. Let us prepare our hearts as we remember the suffering Jesus Christ endured for our sins so that we can be resurrected with him. For Christian Military Academy lecture booklets, the English CMA lecture booklets are free for those who have registered and paid the 30,000 won fee. If you have not paid the fee or not a Shiloh member, but would like a copy, the cost is 10,000 won. Please speak with Deaconess Noel for further inquiries. And Thursday night Bible study, even Thursday night at 9 p.m., Pastor James leads online Bible studies on Book 11, Volume 2. This is followed by a short prayer session. We encourage everyone to participate in this precious time of learning the Word and prayer. And for recruiting volunteers, if you are interested in volunteering in Shiloh, like choir, subtitling, and etc., please speak to General Secretary David Song. We especially need volunteers to help with English subtitles for Shiloh service. Bible scripture readings for this week is Deuteronomy chapter 21 through Joshua chapter 8.
Okay, we do have a new member that's visiting today, and her name is Grace Yoon Eun-hae. And can you stand up? Let's welcome her in the name of the Lord. You are welcome in the name of the Lord. You are welcome in the name of the Lord. I can see it in you, the glory of our King. You are welcome in the name of the Lord. Please sit down. Please sit down. Thank you so much. And I've had a chance to meet Grace when I was over Hephzibah, but now, you know, she's grown up and she's, you know, married and starting a family. So We really congratulate you for visiting. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And we truly welcome you. And please make Shiloh your family. We want to be a family here for you and make it a good environment so that we can grow up together in this community. So thank you for coming. Thanks offerings. Through repentance and reformation, may all Shiloh's families be reborn. Reverend James Park, Reverend Jabez Park, he has given thanks offerings. Thanks offerings for John Kim's first birthday. 장여의 권사님께서 감사금을 드렸습니다. And thanks for all the new beginnings that my family has been given by God. And Eldris Joyce's family has given thanks offerings. And her son, Songchan, has gone into high school. So I knew Songchan when he was like 7 years old. Now he's already in high school. So he's so big. He's really tall, really handsome. So let's give thanks and glory to God. Sarah Kim, thank you for reminding us of our mission to spread redemptive history. And also Andrew Kim, Abby Kim, and John Kim. This is their Thanksgiving offerings for Pyongyang Day. And so thank you so much. And also Daniel Kim, thank you, Father God, for giving me a great government future mobility project. And let the project be used for Father's glory. And he's studying in Seoul University. Are you here, Dan? No, he's not here. But he's studying in Seoul University for his master's. So he's really busy, and his family is really, really supporting him there. And one more announcement that we want to make is that Pastor Jabez is going to go to America next Monday. So we want to give another chance to come and to give us his testimony a little more. So as we met this morning at 9 a.m., we're going to meet again. Like for the period of Lent, we want anybody who can come. So I talked with the president. If you are able to come here at 9 o'clock, we all want to be here so that we'll give a Pastor Jabez a chance to give testimony, you know, a little more time to spend quality time and give us the word. And so that will be at 9 a.m. We're here in Shiloh Sanctuary. So if you have time, please come out just for the period of Lent. So in March and in April, and we'll gather all here together. And also, I just want to give one more. I know that the time is, you know, really gone by, but just one more word of encouragement that I shared this morning. God told the people of Israel through Haggai that the latter glory will be greater than the former glory. And so the people were looking back in Solomon's days, where Solomon was there with the great splendor of the temple and everything was great. But what did God say? God said that the latter glory will be greater than the former glory. And sometimes we think, oh, you know, it was nice when, you know, senior pastor was here and, you know, it was so easy to meet him and, you know, send our prayer requests. But what is God saying? The latter glory will be greater than even those days. And why is that? Because Father's going to come again in his glory. Amen? Do you believe that? And that's going to be a better glory. And not only that, but the glory of the nations, the wealth of the nations are all going to come to this word. They're all going to come. So the glory of the latter days is going to be greater than what we experienced until now. That's an amazing promise. And please hold on to that promise. And so don't look back in the past and say, oh, you know, the latter days or the former days was better. But God is promising us better days. And the latter glory will be better than the former glory. Why? Because he himself will come again, and all of the nations will come to this word. Have that vision, and now let us be able to rise up and be able to work for God with unsparing devotion. And I believe that God will repay you thousands upon thousands, 10,000 upon 10,000. And I pray and bless this upon you in the name of the Lord. Amen. Let us all rise up and have the benediction after we sing hymn number 6.
To Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the everlasting love of our Father, and the presence and the indwelling and the power of the Holy Spirit may rest upon all who have desired to raise up and to be able to work for you, upon our new visitor, Grace Kim, upon our families, upon our businesses, our children, our spouses, upon Shiloh, and upon Korea, from now and forever and evermore. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you so much.